into my eyes and show me. Hello viewer, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's me, Jessica Go, that is speaking. So we are talking about Chacha Eke. So he said he's still in a marriage, so he's still in a marriage. We have to give thanks to God. So as you listen to the rest, don't forget to press like, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and leave your comments according to what you hear.
Hello everyone, my name is Chacha Eke FAANI and I love my life. As you can see from this video, I am pregnant. And as has been peculiar with my former pregnancies, every time I'm pregnant, something in me just erupts. These things that erupt within me have just a few days ago finally gotten the diagnosis of being bipolar disorder. It makes me do crazy things, think crazily, and act crazily. Over the years, I have suffered episodes, and I didn't know what they were, where they came from, these feelings that always made me feel different from the inside. 4 years. On the 3rd of October, I had yet another episode that drove me out of my house. I found myself racing to Zenith Bank to withdraw money to the welcome back of my phone lines that I had destroyed myself. It was as my husband tried to stop me on our way to Zenith Bank that I realized that was even a Saturday. When that failed, still acutely manifesting from bipolar disorder, I found my way to Southgate Hotel, where Nollywood people usually camp and make departures from. Prior to that day, I didn't know I had bipolar, but my husband did. He did, because 2 weeks before the 12th of October, I had had yet another serious episode that landed me at the hospital, still First Delta American Hospital. It was so bad, I regret most of the actions that came with that episode. But my hospital didn't tell me that it was bipolar when I was discharged. Dr. Isiomo Okoba, the doctor and the owner of First Delta American Hospital, they had told my husband on that visit that your wife is bipolar, but my husband was finding better time to bring the news to me when another relapse happened. And it happened this time because he tried to get me to take my meds, to take my medications. And like I said, I didn't know that I was really a bipolar victim, a bipolar patient, I meant to say. I didn't know. But I took out my anger on him when he said, "Did you take your drugs?" And growing up, I didn't used to like to take drugs. I still don't. But look at all the drugs that he gave me from the visit to the hospital 2 weeks ago. Albumet, this is for pregnancy, they said. Olanzapine, famous sulfate, folic acid, B complex, and haloperidol. I started flushing this down the toilet instead of taking them. 3 days I didn't take them, and it resulted in the embarrassing display that I displayed in front of Southgate. My husband said, "Take your drugs," but I got angry with him, like, how dare you try to submit like those doctors and nurses that they were mentally ill. That was his only crime. I flipped it on him like an enemy. Myself saying crazy things like, "I'm leaving my husband. I'm not leaving my husband. I will never leave my husband and my children and my home. My family, having a home, being Mrs. FAANI, and being mother to the beautiful children God has given me is too much blessings to take for granted." And so I say this to as many as are out there that care about me as a person and care about my brand as Chacha Eke FAANI, that I didn't say, and that many bipolar disorder patients say when facing episodes or crisis. I realized that the video I also made defending my husband being alleged to be a wife beater has got some people even distributing more mess. My younger brother, whom the only time I have seen him, whom the last time I had seen him is May 12th last year. I had my son Chimere on the 10th of May 2019. I saw you, Ike, on the 12th of May. I have never set eye on you since then till now. It's over a year, it's almost 2 years. Even when I called you early this year, you didn't pick my call. You didn't return it either. And here you are out there, putting fire where there's none, creating doubt so that no one will know what to believe anymore because you're my family member. But here I am, seated and telling the whole world that personally, as Charity, over the years, even before becoming Mrs. Fanny, there have been an age-long strain between me and the Eke family. So it's no surprise that my brother will come to say things that a detractor would say. Ike, stop it. It's not cute. Stop it, because I deserve better from you as a sibling whom I have been nothing but good to. I also realize that there are colleagues out there who, Victoria Nyama and Georgina Onwaha, I choose to translate your videos and concerns as part of you loving me, because it takes love for someone to go out there and start to make preparations for on behalf of the person. But in this case, there is no need for any alarm that has been raised. And this is not me trying to save my marriage, it's not damage control. I'm pregnant for what would have been my fifth child, if not for one of the most traumatic situations I had in the past, all of which I have said on the transcript into the video. But hey, guys, I'm back. I'm back as Mrs. Fanny. I was discharged from the hospital on the 7th of October. I'm so glad that it's finally in here for waiting to do me since, because if my wife keeps something to bring their wife, I wasn't really understanding. I finally did this drug, I finally know this. That thing called bipolar disorder, I'm one of the many people out there that have it. And no, I'm not ashamed to say that I have it. I'm living my story. I'm the experiencer of these things, and it's a learning process and a growth curve for me, and I'm embracing it totally. I even want to use this opportunity to thank some very good and close family friends of ours, like Benny in Houston, Texas. Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Kula in Atlanta. Thank you, Kenan, where you're also in the Western world and you know about these things and how it comes upon people out there. And so my case is one out of the many cases. It's not something to be ashamed of, I reiterate. In fact, just like I hinted earlier, that we will in motion picture highlight in details my story, because I strongly believe that many women who have left their homes did out of bipolar disorder. They probably didn't know it wasn't diagnosed. In my case, Dr. Enebe, still one of the affiliation from Veterans Better Hospital, sat with me for long hours of diagnosis. He had me explaining my life experiences from when I was a teenager and how something that happened as a teenager left me scarred and untreated. Entirely, I didn't heal from that. Then growing up to having a company with my husband and having to mentally push through and inherent struggles that companies in general face here in Nigeria. All of this have built up into the struggle and depression, have built up into bipolar. But I'm fine now, guys. I missed my meds. That's what happened. I missed my meds. I didn't know I should never do that, and I'll never miss them again. And for my colleagues, like I said earlier, there are some that I'm
I've been so